Yo, crazies, it's me, CrazyNoc, and today we're waiting for Into the Verse Live. All the news, everything we've been waiting for, hopefully, for Season 3, and I got a feeling it's going to be the biggest patch yet. Here we go, crazies, here we go! Into the Verse.
Hello and welcome back, everybody.
Let's go!
Into the Verse, episode number 4. Ajax and Ryan Ross.
Look at number 4.
We once again have Twitch drops coming to you this season. We're very excited about that. Those will start tomorrow with the patch and go on for 1 week.
Over at
we got the Beckon sticker.
CrazyNoc, twitch.tv/CrazyNoc. Look at the top right. They have a Scooby-Doo. They have Scooby's
Mystery Machine. And also make sure you're dropping your quest for right now. We have, of course, not just the stars of the show that have joined the game, but also the original stars of the show, because we were able to bring in all of the original voices.
Whoa!
For the Powerpuff Girls. We got Catherine, E.G. Daily, and Tara Strong.
No way!
Roles as the Powerpuff Girls.
Yep, Bubbles is my favorite. I don't know why.
It's just, there's so much life. Just
that's awesome, though. That's really cool.
But we have the Rattler boys that everybody got to see in the trailer as well.
Nice.
That will be joining completely.
Looks clean.
As well. That is our tier 70 Battle Pass skin, which a couple people have already guessed.
What? How did someone guess that? They're cheating. Last tier of the Battle Pass.
Today, I am here to talk about the Powerpuff Girls joining the Multiverse
nice.
Roster.
Nice! Let's see the full in-depth moveset.
But that doesn't mean that they don't have properties that are unique to themselves. With the Powerpuff Girls passive ability, Sister Act, the Powerpuff Girls can swap between each other using Down Special. Different leaders
nice.
Apply unique attributes to the trio. Bubbles is fast, but her hits have less knockback. Buttercup is slower, but her hits have more knockback. And Blossom is balanced between the two of them. Different leaders also change the properties of the girl's special moves. So, depending on which girl you're using, there is going to be a significant dedicated purpose for using that girl. So now
Damn, that's actually
the
really
Powerpuff
exciting.
Girls normal attacks. The first grounded normal attack we're going to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls dash attack,
that's
which
not
actually
normal.
Has the ability to ring out opponents off of the top. It is a great vertical.
Actually, it didn't even kill at 150.
Move, and you are able to combo off of this move depending on the opponent's damage. The next move that I'd like to talk about is the Powerpuff Girls side attack. Side attack is a three-hit combo that controls a lot of space and goes pretty far.
That is
what
pretty
I mean
far.
By this is if I use the first one, I am able to connect, right? You see how she kind of lunges forward. However, on the second one, I don't always have to try to land the first one. I can space myself in a way where I hit with the second hit of the move, which then will allow me to
That's
still
actually
finish the third hit of the move. Or if I just want
really
to
cool.
maximize spacing as much as possible, I can hit with the final move as well. Again, this move is very fast. They lunge forward, so it has a lot of range, and it will just strictly knock the opponent back. But
and
you can
one
combo
shots.
Into other options with this move traditionally, like other side attacks in the game as well. So you want to be able to use it in that regard too. Powerpuff Girls' grounded neutral attack allows them to slide on the floor towards an opponent. This not only allows them to duck under certain things, but it is a move that is strong and, depending on which girl you are, will determine how strong the move is. Of course, with Blossom, she has a good balance between both strength and speed. Therefore, you're going to hit the move and you're going to send the opponent flying a bit. Bubbles is a bit weaker, so you're going to notice that the opponent doesn't fly as high when getting hit by this move, and Buttercup sends the opponent the furthest. The Powerpuff
Makes
Girls
sense.
Down attack is a good combo starting move that knocks the opponent towards you. It's very
That's insane.
Fast and will have a lot of use at the ledge when your opponent is trying to come up, or if your opponent
Dude,
has
that
a tendency
is insane.
To roll a lot on the ground, this will be a good move to cover that option. As you can see, the girl slammed down the phone and they shoot out towards the opponent.
Oh my god, it's like a Garnet.
To get comboed vertically. You can either send them vertically again if you want
but
upon landing this
10
move,
times as fast.
You can actually use your forward air or anything that will send them horizontally as well. The Powerpuff Girls' grounded up attack is actually pretty cool. They are able to turn into a grounded tornado, vacuuming the opponent and sending them upward.
That seems
the
pretty
awesome
strong.
The thing about this move is not only does it have a lot of range, but it also has the ability to ring out on the top blast zone. And if I was Buttercup in this situation,
Ooh.
I would have a much easier time landing that ring out, which of course adds to just how cool it is to be able to have different unique buffs depending on which girl you are controlling at that time. Use this move as a great anti-air tool or even as an approach tool, as you can actually combo into it with a jab.
Jeez, that seems pretty damn strong.
Powerpuff Girls grounded special attacks. Neutral special on the ground allows the Powerpuff
Girls
to each use a unique ability.
The new abilities.
The potential to either ring out an opponent
or
be comboed into. So, depending on which one you do, will have pretty much a use that is unique to each girl. The next move I'd like to talk about is side special on the ground. Side special on
there
the ground has the ability to send out a girl to grab an opponent and actually throw them. If I'm controlling Blossom, Buttercup will be thrown and throw the opponent down. I am able to actually combo off of this because of the ground bounce, and if I want to use this at the ledge, I can throw the opponent downward under the stage to try to set up for an edge guard. If I'm controlling Bubbles,
it's like Superman to fly and a bee at the same time.
Blossom will throw the opponent back towards the girls so that they can combo off of it. And if I am controlling Buttercup and I throw Bubbles, I'm actually able to throw the opponent upward and either ring out off of this, or I can actually just apply more damage depending on how far they go when I throw them, which varies depending on, of course, the opponent's damage percentage. So you want to use this to
not only pressure opponents in neutral, but
of course to combo off of it as well and set up for ringouts. Something cool is that if you hold this move, the girl will go further. So this is what it looks like if I tap. This is what it looks like if I hold. Much different. And if
Very
you want to
learn
even more moves that the Powerpuff Girls have to offer, be sure to check out the official Multiversus YouTube channel and of course drop a subscription. We will be uploading the rest of this breakdown to the official YouTube channel for you all to watch right after this episode of Into the Verse.
Nice.
So thank you so much for watching. This has been the Cat, your
community
manager.
I liked how they shrunk it down from last time. Very concise.
We've already seen.
I like that a lot. She looks great. They all look great.
The way to combo and string together is actually very straightforward. And for anybody who's looking, they might notice something different on the training here too.
Whoa! We are currently
doing some review and additions to the lab. We have returned the combo counter to the lab as well. And there will be more stuff coming in the near future. So apologies for the fact that you're going to hear Mojo pretty often, as he likes to speak every time I reset.
Freaking Mojo.
Your down attack pulls people in. It allows you to follow up and get easy combo.
Oh, that's not true, Ajax.
Up special.
I saw the stun combo.
Your jabs are also great because you could use that low percents to string into down attack. But it's not just that.
She seems very fast.
Unique that we have never done before. Their signature perk, called Rainbow Dash, will actually allow you to input a dash attack in the air. We have never.
Whoa!
So what you get to do is do stuff like nair, buffer into dash
attack. Whoa! I like it.
Also usually only follows the floor. This one sends straight up. But if you hold up, you can actually go into the air to be able to chase after someone instead, which at lower percents will let you follow up too. So a big key factor, which we'll learn a lot later, combo expression, character uniqueness, and skill expression for players in general. We're trying to expand on that a ton this season. So it won't just be, you know, even though Jab is a great combo starter. Of course,
beautiful to hear.
Which you could get.
Beautiful. I could kiss him right on the cheek.
At lower, at higher percents, it's easy to DI out of. But when you go for things such as the grabs, which all of them have different grabs, as you saw from Nakat.
So she throws down.
You have Bubbles.
Bubbles throws up.
Towards you, which is easy to follow up on. You have Buttercup, who uses... Get down from there. Buttercup is more of a KO throw, which will have Bubbles send out and send straight up. But there's something super unique about this throw as well. When there's multiple characters, usually there's unique ways to play multiple characters in a kit. One of those things being, of course, desyncs, which you can actually do. So if you decide to use a throw and you dodge during it, you could actually move up further so you could get a follow-up that you normally wouldn't.
Whoa!
So you can line up stuff like this, or get down from there. Mojo, talk again. Thank you very much. You have Buttercup. At higher damage windows, the eye laser is a very strong KO option, but you can't combo into it unless you do this.
Ah, so you can close that gap and get in close during the grab.
Yes. So there's a lot of depth to this character. There's a lot of unique ways.
It's crazy.
You could also do things.
No knock.
Mojo. When you get knocked out, you will remain the character that you were on.
So okay, we're going with Bubbles.
Yeah, there are a lot of...
Damn, they're so good at implementing characters in this game.
And something that
I gotta give it to them every time.
So we're ever gonna see new stuff come to old characters? Are we going to see reworks come to older characters? Stay tuned for about 20 minutes from now. So,
whoa! Reworks!
There's a lot of unique stuff to them. They're a lot of fun.
Superman buffs.
Not the only thing. A brand new map that will be joining this.
Oh, yeah, we did
well.
See a couple. Who is that in the back? What are these
really
TVs?
Feel like a unit, which I feel like is such a unique.
Yeah,
my
like
brain is thinking Jigsaw.
This one is a lot of fun. This is our first.
Whoa! First look at the Gremlins map. I can tell. It looks great.
You have the pillar over here, which also includes a little gremlin kind of hanging for.
Yeah.
But the pulley system is interesting because when you land on the pulley system, it'll make this one go down.
And then
it'll go
up.
Make the opposite side here.
I knew it. I'm so smart. I'm so smart. Holy shit. This better be in ranked.
Now all they've got is the wall.
I love this.
Yeah.
A wall and a dream.
More maps like this, man. That's so great. I did not think they would be animated in the back. No way. They actually cheer.
They don't care who wins or loses.
When someone gets stuck, that's actually so cool. Holy shit. Well.
Will not actually
well
move.
Done on this map. Unbelievable.
Off, so they will stay.
That's insane.
Essentially turn into additional platforms.
Yes. And then for the 1v1 version, since this is a very large stage overall, the pulleys are actually gone. It's brought in a little bit more.
It makes sense.
So that will.
I'm so glad that it seems like it's going to be ranked, which it should. I love this.
Yeah, a lot of focus. No.
Love.
The individual girls have different powers. But when you use the extra ingredient, it'll add on the elemental base portion. So you get 4 stacks of frost from neutral special.
That actually is a significant amount of ice.
It'll add a small stun, which will allow you to get a
wow.
Use the stun.
I can see this perk being used 100%.
If you actually hit the opponent, it lights them on fire.
Buttercup thinks she's better than Superman.
Kind of
destroy Townsville.
That's the mid-season map,
which is just if the two platforms were broken, like the Townsville version of Mojo Jojo. It is our smallest center platform stage. It is 1v1 exclusive.
Oh, okay.
So it is,
it's so obvious.
1, 2, 3. Buttercup.
It's Bubbles.
Oh. No way. Okay, Buttercup. Bubbles has the best personality.
I agree, Bubbles. I thought they were talking about the map.
Buttercup, personal.
I haven't even watched the show, and I can already tell Bubbles is the best.
Of course, a new ranked season that will be coming.
Yes! Yes, ranked! Ranked, please, improvements!
Will include...
Superman,
ranked skin. If you want to pull that up right there, as everybody saw with the last season, make sure you get.
It is cool. Don't get me wrong. They are cool. That looks badass. But I'm.
And of course, with
so sad we don't get other skins. They can make up for it for the information.
We had a lot of learning to. So for starters,
you learned in the beta, right?
If you were in Diamond or Master, when you go into the next season, if you have any character in Diamond or Master, the first time you play. Additional character, whatever altered character you want, you will be bumped up to Silver 5 or Gold 5. So that way you're going right out of the early ranks. You're not queuing with anybody down in Bronze or Silver or any of that to help one.
I thought they already changed that.
If you are starting in Diamond. But if you are trying new characters, it'll help speed up the process. It'll help move people away from the lower ranks, so that way you're playing people more on your level.
So they
it makes sense.
Well, to other characters, even if
but
they've got
I feel like if you just play the ranked,
yeah, and again, a lot of
it should automatically do that anyway, without forcing it.
And then for defeating a player of higher tiers than you, you now will receive a higher minimum RP gain. Before the MMR calculation, there was a bit of inconsistency for some people when they would beat someone, say, in Master and they were in Platinum. And wondering why they weren't getting enough RP. Well, we have made an adjustment towards that. So we want to make sure that when you are beating someone at a higher skill level,
we'll
you aren't
see.
Getting properly rewarded for that. Same thing.
All right, we'll
on
see how much
end.
That is.
If you are losing to someone of a higher tier that you happen to match with someone who's a little bit higher up, a pretty big difference in MMR, there'll be a lower overall RP loss gain for everyone.
Okay.
As we continue to pay attention to ranked, of course, the values, if we don't believe that they're working enough from what we're seeing, we will go in and tune those in with hot fixes. We're going to be keeping an eye on that actively throughout the season. So it's not just, hey, everybody, this is the Band-Aid. This is the guaranteed answer to what we're doing right now. We'll be keeping an active eye on that.
In general, know that we are pretty
much constantly newer. All right, we'll see how that works.
Newer.
Such easy fixes.
We have switched to open school to allow it. So if you are, say, a brand new player, you're joining us for the first time here for Season 3. Welcome, if you are. You will not be paired right away into someone who's been playing. While you're more likely to be paired into someone who's closer to your rank or a newer player. Likewise, if you are someone who, say, took a break for a little bit, you took a break for the season or you had a couple of the games you want to try out, you're coming back, you're getting ready to grind ranked again.
You took a vacation, work got busy, you know, kids, whatever it may be.
Yeah, and you're worried that your first match you're going to show up and it's the number two ranked overall player. And you're like, oh, wow.
I'm out of practice.
Yeah, that won't be happening. We're also looking at all right. We also changed the same thing for that. So if you haven't played for a little bit, your first matches that. As you get in an upcoming future patch will also be showing win streaks. So if you see someone who has that 10 win streak and you want to get rid of that,
that's cool.
But also
you should have like an RP bounty on them.
Oh yes, we also raised the target MMR overall for Master Rank. With the beginning of last season, we did start with the best of ones and it switched to best three over time, and we saw a lot of people race very quickly to Master, and which kind of led to a position where a lot of people were trying really hard to get to Grandmaster rank at the end of the season, but so many people were so close, it kind of created a big wall for everybody to get through. So now we have a greater, bigger target for it. So once you get the Master, you will feel you earned that rank to get there. And it will be much more, not only much more satisfying, but also make it easier once we get up to that Grandmaster rank to be able to see people fluctuate. And if you are Master 1 or higher, so Grandmaster or Master 1, you will have an active decay. If you not play for a bit. So RP will decay for inactivity. So you can't just go all the way to number one and hold that position.
You have to defend your title.
How fast is the decay, though?
Keep Rick Sanchez, which is Rick Prime. That is your first 10th tier skin for...
Oh, nice. I actually don't even remember Rick Prime in the show. Is that like, there's so many variants of him. 32,000.
Of course, that is not the only one. We have a lot more.
But wait, there's more.
There's more, which some of you, of course, did see the Mystery Incorporated.
And that is a good scam right there.
Of course, that is not all. We have brand new taunts coming in for LeBron.
Finally, LeBron buffs, guys. He got the autograph.
Of course.
So I don't want to see any LeBron mains complaining anymore.
I know that the Garnet players are staring at it. Got the trade.
That's basically
Garnet,
my mood.
Which will also be
Suns out, guns out.
The smooch, which will make them disappear. And everybody's new favorite ring out. I cannot wait to use this one.
This is going to be everywhere.
I am so happy to see this one.
Salty
I
emote.
Expect everybody to...
No world in which this stays just a touch of salt.
True. How many be using that day one?
Because we also got the Karate Chaos Tom and Jerry skin. This is actually my personal favorite one. I'm a big fan of this one.
I didn't know martial arts had a tilt paddle and a dare.
Very important one.
Whoa!
I'm so excited about this skin.
I like that one as well.
Phenomenal, over and over again. But one that
the character's more developed.
Michelle Walker and one of my new favorite ringouts as well. Get the
Ooh.
W. It's a dragon based ringout. This one,
Game of Thrones love.
Really
Hold on.
Oh my god! Are you kidding me?
We gotta.
Does it actually work? That is a top tier. That is a. That
no,
is.
No, there's no chance.
That
Wait,
is
no.
Okay, maybe this
a amazing idea for a banner. God damn it, now I'm looking at it.
All right, but we do have, of course, the Justice Lord Black Adam,
Ooh.
Which is another skin that will be joining Unique Animation.
That's a good skin right there.
This one is really cool.
You know,
it is really cool, I agree.
And, of course, the Quintessence Lady, who has a freaking chainsaw
what?
For a sword.
You know, why did they give a demigod a
What
chainsaw?
The hell?
I don't know, but we're big fans of the death metal comics. Well,
what the hell? That skin looks
that
really
is,
good, though.
Of course,
too bad she's going to get nerfed.
Content. We like to update the Prestige store, which
okay.
we just talked about. Death Metal Batman, which will also be joining. It's got spikes on the shoulders. This one's just cool. Like
it's cool.
Holy
like,
shit, that
I really
is cool.
I don't know how else to put it. And,
Batman is getting
Superman!
Superman!
Just got the cyber skin a little while ago. Well, congrats. He got a new one.
Oh my god!
Superman.
I literally had someone in my chat just really talking about the death metal Superman.
To be a battle.
Oh my god, that looks good.
We have the announcer pack for the Rowdy Rough Boys in the Prestige store as well.
Is that another super
two favorite banners?
Oh my god!
Lasers, you see bullets flying off. This one, I don't know how
That's good.
Switch off those.
I'm not gonna switch off that ever.
Yeah,
that is amazing.
Cool. It's shout out
holy
to the
shit. All right.
Putting these out the last prestige skins. So that's a lot of the
holy
new content
shit.
We're seeing. Of course, that is not the
all right. That'll hold me off till season 4. Jeff, are you seeing that?
Man,
look at it.
We still got more.
Give us more. All blacked out skin. Oh, that looks so good.
The detail's incredible.
There also happens to be a celebration event coming up pretty soon, which is the Batman 85th
anniversary.
Whoa! Our man,
holy shit!
He's so old!
He's so old!
Why
that
is
he
so old?
Who are you? Those are some good skins right there. Those skins look great.
You are going to get the skins. You actually will be able to get currency to unlock some of the older skins as well for Batman. So you'll be able to get currency that could be used for the Batman animated skin, the Samurai Batman. So if you're not necessarily...
Oh, nice!
We had to bring the girls in to stop it. So we got Sugar Spice and Lasers. Another unique thing which you would not see just yet is our companion juice.
That's cool.
Much like Toasty. And I forgot who else we added in the last one. But you will also be able to get individual companions for the girls themselves.
Alright, what's it like on Insanity?
That's where you get to have the individual time.
Looney mode.
Girls.
But we do want to show them the art, though. We got to show them ripped art.
We do, of course. Like we said, this is That Time Is Over ripped. Some of you might have noticed, actually, while I was in training mode with
Dear Lord,
the
baby Jesus.
You can approach a lot easier with aerials. You can move a little bit easier in the air. And a reason for that is because we have done a pretty big overhaul to the way that works. And when I say pretty big, I mean pretty much every single character in the game has been changed in some way or another.
Whoa!
So we have a couple of videos to show off that first. Let's go ahead and pull up the first one.
I'm here for it. Let's hear it.
The visuals kind of give it to you straightforward. Before you would get clamped as you tried to go for certain moves, it was ways to help position and line things up.
Way more momentum, less floaty.
Down the way that
that's a huge difference.
Exactly.
That's like increased by 100% plus.
Now what we have done, you're going to be moving faster in the air with or without dodge boosting. But dodge boosting, as you can see, you're moving a couple square units
even further
than you were before. And it's not
even without the dodge boost.
On charge based aerials too. So charge boosts, you stop in position normally, no matter what. But with this new change, you can actually approach with charge based aerials too. So
keeps
this is
the flow.
Helma, you got.
That's
like
huge.
Dog,
that is a.
Aerials, you have anybody
it's like a small change, but a huge effect. That's really nice.
Also, map your trajectory.
Shaggy
your
skin right there. By the way, you're looking really handsome.
Limit reach. With some of those aerials. And also speaking of that, we have done that to other characters too, such as Garnet. You were able to fall faster with the down air. And something we've done to multiple characters as we move to the other clip for Garnet here, there is improved grounded-based combo routes too. You have, for one, Garnet players might notice we have added armor to the down attack when you charge it. But also, the grounded downward hit will ground bounce more often. It would only work if somebody DI'd downward before. So now you can line up more combos there.
Bam.
A lot easier to lose after.
Even more hits done. I don't know.
Aerials also have some new ground bounce based setups. So for characters like Jake, we added in that unique input. A lot of people ask if you work at certain percent windows to get the follow up off of ground bounce. But you don't always have to do that. You can land with Nair now and get a jab follow up, get a down attack follow up, get a jab,
nice.
Or anything like that. And something super important is we have improved branch windows on some characters too. As you can see, Banana Guard, known as the two button champ before, because a majority of what you do with side air and air side special,
the speed right there,
are all pretty much KO options. So for characters that were lacking, would you ever rework moves? Would you ever add new moves? And the answer to that before has been yes, and we just didn't have anything to show. Well, now we do. Let's go ahead and pull up exactly what we have done to Batman. So,
what'd you do to
Batman,
him?
Batman is one of those characters where the whole game plan kind of became one to two goals only. Use dash attack, or use dive kick, utilizing things like the jab jab IAD side air, which was a loop that was a little unhealthy to play against.
Almost yes, all of his ring outs were true. Either kicks.
You have a brand new dash attack called Bam Pow.
This
is a double punching dash attack that is an armor breaker that will also ground bounce. But over at higher percents, it'll send them further out. This allows people to land with things such as side air, because it was very hard to get a side air follow-up. So now you have a landing approach option with side air to get a grounded hit. Thank you, Shaggy, for kicking me in the face. And for people who are wondering,
he's still overpowered.
The slide is now on down tilt. But what happened to the other kick? What happened to his armored kick? Well, now that's an active input. So when you use down attack and you input it again, you were able to go into the old sweep. So, on cooldown based attacks, by nature, were weaker because the idea was to not make it so you just get rid of them and use it. However, we got to a point where we ended up having moves that were a little bit too weak by comparison. So you have things like the punch, which will now ground bounce. So you can use that not only as a grounded option.
Yeah, there's never a reason to use those on cooldown moves ever. I like in everything I hear. I'm just having fun listening.
LeBron James was someone who
LeBron
James was like the epitome of on cooldown. One of the biggest changes to this character, his down air always had to be particularly hit in a certain spot in order to get a proper spike. That is not the case anymore. They will always spike. And you could go for tech chase reads on that. We sped up basically everything. So the unarmed jab is faster. The slap can now instantly be buffered.
Wow.
So down attack will now ground bounce again.
Lots of ground bouncing. Yeah, holy shit. I don't know how I feel about that.
In general, the ground was not being utilized enough.
Skill expression is the theme of this patch. Is the biggest thing. We want to improve movement.
I approve.
In future patches, we could be looking at some changes to dodges to make them less powerful overall. It's very difficult with
dodging. Oh my god.
Pretty instantly after you.
Oh my god. Thank you. A few more that just made me erect. Dude, I'm hyped. They say there's a lot of changes.
Or anything that we can do to make it more fun, more exciting, just quality of life improvements across the board. We're constantly going to be chasing those changes. So please
keep us up to date.
Feedback. We do hear you guys.
I know you guys hear us, but please let us know what you hear.
We pay attention to those things, and we want to make sure that we can do whatever we can to try and make this game the best it can be.
Looking at, so a lot of people have been asking about mini games and how they operate and what they do. Well, we're looking into adding a unique queue in the near future, which will have PvP mini games in them, amongst other things. So we're looking forward to getting that in there. A lot of people are asking about that.
That'd be huge.
There's also going to be mutators for custom games coming into the near future. So those mutators that you see in Rifts, you'll be able to do unique matches. So if you want to create someone, have everybody be fast, everybody have slows, whatever you want. So all the mutators we're looking into adding.
That's huge.
The lab, like we mentioned before, it's got the new hit stun counter. The lab is receiving a overhaul in general with the UI, which will be coming in the near future. So we're really looking forward to that.
What is the near future? 2026.
How the difficulty it is to set up certain specific situations in the lab and how you do that. Well, we'll be adding.
I'm still wrecked, guys. It won't go down. And, I've never had the desire to go to lab, hardly, because it's so difficult to actually want to try things.
We've still got more.
Oh, tournaments! Actual official invited tournaments! Nice!
Our very first supported local event called Ring Out, which will be happening at the HyperX Arena over in Las Vegas. We're very excited to be able to start looking into different ways to support not just the local events,
dude. It sucks that it's local, just because.
So make sure you keep an eye out on MVS Gaming Twitter.
I can't be mad, man. Just the fact that they're branching out into that.
Super excited about this one. Wow. It's kind of like I'm keeping it kind of professional.
I told you guys. This is the best direction.
That's fair.
Patch. More of a direction than season 1 and 2 combined. All right, questions, Q&A.
Can alternate colors be a thing?
That one actually gets asked about quite a bit. You hear that often, and that is definitely a really cool idea. So
it's definitely on our radar.
Game is what they mean.
Are there any plans to improve the friends list? Quality of life changes, like being able to see various info of whether or not the match, whether in their group, last login, etc.
That's asked for quite often. It's like, can we get them in alphabetical order to be able to find people?
Keep it together.
We are looking into those type of things for the friends list. So keep an eye out for upcoming patches in the future.
All the UI could use quality of life improvements.
Are there plans or consideration for a random skin button for characters?
That would be cool.
We are looking to try and make it so people can utilize more skins more often. A lot of
that'd be a no-brainer.
Like, projectiles that are dodged lose their hitbox and are unable to hit again, but still remain visible. So phantom projectiles. Is this an intended mechanic, or is it a bug that's going to be fixed?
So yes, but there is some additional caveats to that. So something that people were going to see tomorrow in the patch notes is for Marvin, when projectiles are dodged through, when they come back after a button is used, they just don't hit anybody. Well, the button will now reset the hit counter, so every time when you use a button, it will hit them on the way back through. We forgot couch tree. Oh my god, hold on.
I don't have anything. Oh wait. But what does this mean?
Whoa! Wicked Witch! Wait, right? Just kidding. I was thinking of like Snow White and the Apple, the Witch Apple, but people are saying Marceline? I haven't seen enough of Adventure Time to know an apple. I've seen her a couple times, but crazies, that's it. That is Into the Verse. We got so much stuff. I think the rank changes are minimal. Like, they're not really crazy changes, but they could have a big impact. The combat overall seems absolutely phenomenal. Overall, just aerial speed is what got me about the bus. And that they said they're focusing on the combat, so it's a big highlight. But let me know what your thoughts are. Insane Superman skins as well. Holy shit. Crazies, thank you all for watching. Have a great rest of your day and rest up for tomorrow, baby. Season 3, let's go! Let's go!